Why do we age Papa Brews twice as long as the guilds require? Because what's a couple more turns when you have five generations looking over your shoulder? Don't even think about it.
Available at Morass's Market.
If the world makes you feel ordinary, we assure you it's lying. We urge you to find your own peculiar talent. Perhaps we may be of some assistance. This announcement brought to you by...
Well, hello, everyone, and happy Saturday and happy Propaganda Day. This is Deluxe here with a version of Brute Squad. A lot of you are asking if all that glitters would work in this. And at first I said no, because this deck likes to go wide and not really care about quality. It's about kind of evasion, big surprise, right? Most of my decks are. But I've made room for it with the old list in mind. We're going to go over it here. So the mana base is the same. I've got four dens, four holdouts, one solitary plane, cool Equinox art, and four seats. We've got our Ornithopter, Sprigleaf Drum, and Ginger Brute, all four ofs. And now this is one of the big changes, Vault Scourge. When you add up the humans to the non-humans because of one mind, we're only one off. So I think we're one human shy compared to the other ones, or it might be vice versa. How did I do that? Well, I got rid of the Tooth of Chisgora. And the Harsh Sustenance main, moved it to the sideboard, made room for three more humans and bodyguard because we do care a little bit more about quality. So I wanted a little bit of an option to protect our investment if we do hit all that glitters, which actually the majority of the time you want to put it on a Ginger Brute. There's quite a few flyers in the format, and you go up against elves, they even have all the creatures with reach and everything. So thank you for that, Popper Tim in the house, Shirazaman. All right, and my step throw here, nice and early as always. Love the early birds. Anyway, in our sideboard, we got three Prismatic Strands. This isn't so much for red as it is for like Stompy or Elves or decks that are trying to do the same thing, just get there that, you know, turn or two sooner. This, as you all know, double-sided Wrath of God, if you play it right, it's pretty nuts. And we got enough white creatures to support it. I skimped on one blue Elemental Blast, went down to the five count here. We've got three in the festivities, one Harsh Sustenance. This is always good for those strong fog locks or whatever, and you can always target a creature with it too and gains you life. And three relics, very on theme with this deck. So I was going to bring you a new deck that I was working on this whole week called the Black Clock, and it's not doing as well as I wanted it to. And after last week's pummeling, I my ego needed a little bit of a break, so I had to play something that at least probably is going to be 50% or better on the day. So just being fully honest and transparent with y'all, I can only take so many hard lickings. But I've been always obsessed with this Underworld Dreams mentality, right, where you have ill-gotten gains and dogged pursuit and the curse, trespasser's curse and such, and always love those kind of cards. And I was trying to not do a black burn, but do just something of my own that way. Ooh, boy, can't ask for a much better hand than this. We'll keep this. Let's open up both yards here. Bloop, there we are, and off we go. Thanks for joining me nice and early here, everybody. We'll lead off with a Thopter. And I'm actually going to lead off with a seat here, in case they do have that really rare turn one land destruction. I'd rather the seats aren't as important as the white. You can get really marooned if you don't have white mana in this list. So, yo. All right. Here we go. Another big UFC fight tonight. I'm not too excited about this one. I'm not going to get this one. I don't think Strickland has a chance. He's like just a refrigerator of punches that just moves forward. I think Izzy's going to just be able to totally piece him apart, but whatever. There's a few thoughts here, but I'm going to bring out our human. Try to settle the score here. This way, if we do top deck a land, we can act like we're mana screwed and play into Spell Pierce so that they counter an Nuvwan Mind and we can stick in all that glitters. A maroon. All right. Don't be a snap. Okay, good. I was going to say, at this stage, if this is like a counter-heavy list, it's always fun to just sit back and, okay, I'll just hit you for four every turn while you wait and not use that counter spell. Alrighty, this works out really, really, really good. This is brutal. We're going to bring this out. I mean, if they have snap, then they're right back in this, but I don't really miss the tooth all that much. I was really surprised by that. It's a really awesome combat trick. Got two options here. We could have one mine, or we could really hit hard and do this. Might as well gain the life. Let's go. Come on over for nine on turn. What is this, three? Nine in the air. Pretty great. That's what really like these quality aggro strategies where, you know, like I was just saying, if they are on counter spells, they can't wait to do it. All right, well, we got in for six. Only going to net three life after we replay that Scourge. Bounce going to be a lot more prevalent as all that glitters gets more and more popular. Yeah, I like Onslaught a lot. Not the expansion, but the card. I've always tried to make that work in Goblins, and I always end up losing it for just, you know, three damage spell or something. Pretty weird. Yeah, the Pauper Classic Tuesday tournament didn't fire this week because there was some MTGO downtime scheduled at exactly the same time, so that was really frustrating. I was looking to get my first place. I got second the week before, and I wanted revenge. I didn't make any tweaks either. It was just a top deck error. All right. Let's see what we can grab here. We'll have one mind and fall into some good stuff. We'll do it again. This deck is disgusting sometimes. My son's always said it's his favorite of the ones I've designed, meaning, you know, just Brute Squad in general. I think it's because we played a lot of tabletop during COVID, and I had this sleeved up, and there were so many turns like that one where I would just draw four or five cards, like, regularly. Let's rinse, repeat. Here comes some more. Here comes some more. A Glacial Floodplain. Fascinating. Woo. Okay. Looks like we're on a slower build of familiars here. Probably got a Spell Snare and a Snap in company. We will still rush right on over. Is it worth that? Now it is. All right. Let's bring back the Ancient Den. I don't think Glitter's going to get banned. It's pretty easy to deal with. And it's already in the shell of... you know, I'm going to put this on our Ornithopter. I don't really need much else. It's really diversify stuff. They want to snap that. That's fine. Here comes a snap or a counter. Gonna let it go. Interesting. All right. Well, I guess we got to come in with all these boys. Let's do it like this. Sure, there's some trick coming our way. Probably a snap. Yep. Boing, and they're gonna kill the Glint Hawk. And that we're only going to get in for half damage here. Glitter's being, you know, the other night. Oh, I'm going to be uploading today a rare thing. Last night I had one of the best games. I think his name was Soms, S-O-M-S or something. He's on our clan if you're curious. But he was playing Black Sack as I last designed it, and I was playing this. We had the most epic game. It went to game three. And it was just one of those games of the ages sort of things. And down to the wire, it was just like it was scripted or something. So I recorded the whole thing, and I'm going to upload it later along with this video. So hopefully that doesn't cause any sort of confusion. But it's just worth watching. I'll put a nice soundtrack behind it and not too much production behind it, just the game. Oh, Twitch is making it harder to log in. Yeah, when I got my new PC, I was really dreading all the passwords and this, that, and the other, but it was, you know, took a few hours. I had to write everything down, and I like to take actual pictures of my passwords written down on paper with like my chicken scratch and like some of my little cipher codes and stuff, so that even if they have the picture, they can't figure it out. But then sometimes if enough time goes by, I look at it and I go, what the hell did I mean by that? Get all screwed up. All right, they're right back in it, gaining some life, drawing a whole lot of cards. This is my original build. You know, I had access to a few journeys, help punch through some damage, but right now really need like a ginger brute. I think they're going to be gaining a little bit too much life here. Yeah, I can't really. If I swing with everything, I lose the hawk. I got to put this out now. Actually, maybe I should wait till after combat. Doesn't make too much sense to swing with everything, does it? Course, if I just swing with the Oriok, I can kill Mole Drifter, and they don't really have all that many options for Ephemerate. They're going to take it. Yeah, I think that's a good call. Maybe they wouldn't know if they knew I had this, but yeah, Ephemerate's a little bit too much value for them to go past. Oh yeah, there's a few. Speaking of wraths, that new black one that something sorrow, 1 and 2 black lets you scry. I'm having a lot of fun with that and that clock list. Started with 4. It's a little overkill. Went down to 2 and then 2-2 split with the sideboard. But I started this other black list with like I think it was 18 lands, which statistically was correct, and I kept getting screwed. So I went up to 19, then I went to 20, then I went to 21. Now I'm at 22, and I still will just, it's so hard to hit that third land. I don't know if it's an art thing or what, but oh, right, they're going to win this one. They're just pulling out of this. This is what this deck does. We weren't fast enough. Hey, X and Rouge in the house. Good to have you with us, my friend. How are things? They need an update. All right. Harsh would be good here. Relic. Don't want to overboard, but do need some help in this list. Thanks a lot, list. All right. I'm going to go over with our boys here. We'll probably lose the Hawk. No, it's not a Blackburn list. It's something I've been wanting to construct for a long time, and I just call it the black clock. And it's just a constant, just every turn there's, you know, more and more stuff, just one a turn, and then 2 a turn, 3 a turn, and then, you know, you get that kind of lightning bolt every turn, just static effect. And it takes quite a bit to get there. I've really considered dark rituals and stuff, but at the end of the line, I was just losing a little bit too much with it. And I just felt like I was bringing you guys an unfinished deck. So I'm going to give it another week or maybe 2. Hopefully not 3. It's not going to be a metagame breaker or anything like that. It's just, you know, one of those creative lists that I like to, you know, get your, I don't know, creative mind flowing, or like, well, if you cornered it with this, that would be pretty cool. So here comes the life. They got too many cards. If we draw another land here, I'll probably scoop. This is getting pretty bleak. I know an outsider would look at the life and go, what do you mean? You just had it one more time. It's like, that's not how these things work. Yeah, they've got me locked up. All right. What a great comeback. My Cattle Plays. Let's see. Familiars. Start off with an L. Let's see if we can improve that. Ooh, let's go. Well, I want one of these. I like our bodyguards. I think I'm only going to bring in 2 relics. So I got to make room for 3 things. Really, really want Ginger Boot to show up. I don't really care about the Inspector or the Recruits can probably hang back. I don't want to lose too many humans. That's what I'm looking for. I think maybe a Glinthawk or a Brute. Let's lose 1 brute. Let's try this out. And like this deck, 13 lands, right? A Of course, we have the drum package and everything, but and obviously it's built to, you know, you only need one or two mana tops. But so many like that and elves and stuff. I almost played elves today. I've got a new list I've been working on with that as well. If you have one, send it to propaganda@gmail.com. I'm trying to see if I can redesign that to be a lot different. But anyway, you know, these lists that have crazy low mana, they always seem to just, oh, there's one. You know, it's when you need to have that second or third mana almost very consistently. That's incredibly hard to have happen. Yeah, we want to go first. Okay. That's definitely seen better hands. We can lead off with the Brute into a Bodyguard here. Not sure if this is a winning hand, though. You know, we need to be fast. We do have the protection of the Bodyguard. If we top deck a... I'm going to mulligan this. Very flooded for this kind of... Oh, boy, we really paid the price there. We got to mulligan this. This is why you need artifact creatures. I used to run Flare Husk instead of the Vault Scourge. Just cannot... even though that mana is there. This one I might keep just because... Oh, boy. I do have Ginger Brute. Can't go too much deeper here, but man, this is we're really getting screwed here. I'm gonna mulligan this. All right, wow, we are hurting, guys. Put three cards back. Well, we're not gonna be hitting Thoughtcast anytime soon, or this, or one of these. This is gross. We are definitely probably losing just a mulligan here. It's nice having the one basic in here in case, you know, you do get a Cleansing Wildfired or something like that. You have that access. Of course, my experience, when you're up against that person, you have a hand like this where you open with it and then you don't have anything to fetch for. But I found that one extra was very needed. Here, I was just talking about how, oh, this deck only needs this many lands. And then I get clobbered like that. But it happens. Did have plenty of lands and a lot of those ones we put back. And the first one, we had too many. Maybe should have kept that. Easy to say in hindsight, right? Ooh, I've never been a fan of Biograph Mindstab. I know it's a lot of card for what it does, but I just doesn't seem... Like when we were playing the Thopter list a couple weeks back, you know, just so many things. You know, like look at Healer's Hawk, right? It has flying and lifelink, so you get evasion and that, and then you just make it bigger or better if you want to. Sometimes when you get those big bodies, it's just everything stops them. Yuck! This is gross. I don't like this at all. I think for tempo's sake, we'll return the Brute. This is about as bad as it gets for this list, as far as like just clunky draws, triple mulligan. Now we're really stultified. Oh, for sure, Dreamer Singer. That's so true. Earnum Jin. Yeah, that was that five toughness is a whole lot. I even like that new 6/6 trample life gain dude that came out. You know, if you bargain, it ends up costing like five mana or something. 3/2. I was like, wow, that's pretty cool. You know they got snap. If we go to a game 3, I might even ditch all that glitters. As crazy as that sounds. This is only for one, so. Well, let's give the illusion that we have some counter magic, right? I probably know better. Attack. Whoa. Big surprise. I've seen the Ginger Brew three turns. I don't think we're going to get there, guys. Triple mulligan, and unless they just never hit white here. Broker's Hideout suggests that they have it, though. Why else would they have done that? I do love that new black bargain card, though. Rowan's, I don't know, Retreat, or I forget what it's called. And sacrificing an enchantment for that, man. You can dig like six cards deep sometimes. It's nuts. There's that 3/5 fairy too that gains life. I'm talking about limited for Wilds of Eldraine that had a lot of fun with. I had two of those and two of the green guys, and it really kept me in a lot of games. I could just gain 3 life and have some massive blocker. But yeah, again, to that 5 butt damage you were talking about, that's an Urnam Jinn. That's so true. Okay, what are we walking into here? Bring out the drum. Is it worth it all that glitters right now? And we'll probably walk right into a spell pierce, but I'd actually rather that than a snap at this point, given our board state. At least we'll get in for some respectable damage here. You know they got snap. It's just, in fact, the last night's game, there was my opponent was playing Black Sack, and he brought in all of the enchantment removals with a debt to the Kami. And it was incredibly effective, because that's really, if you just call enchantment, you get rid of my ace, right? And so I think it was the third game. I just took out all that glitters. Just watched him just have a hand filled up. Whoa, Apollo Pub 100. Thank you. Good to see you, man. This is game 2. We lost the first game. We almost got him against the ropes, and then they started gaining life and doing the graveyard thing. And we just conceded once they had the ephemerate lock with the wizard. You're a wizard, Harry. And here comes the planes, soon to be the life. I'm not sure what this is going to do. Pretty good card against all that glitters as well. I love the first-time chatters. Thanks for being brave, throwing your name out into the ether. All right. Let's go like this. Right here. We'll return. Oop. This, please. Boink. Really need a human to show up. This is getting really weird. Boop. I'm not sure if it's worth attacking at this point. I think I'd rather draw the cards. Hate doing this. I mean, we triple mulligan. Now, this is like the clunkiest sequence ever. But pay our dues. We'll drop that human, which they probably won't care about, as they have so many... four toughness style things, so many. One, but Iron Record definitely seems a little subpar. Taking way too long. Here comes the engine. They'll probably find a Fim right here, and then it's just a cascade from there. As long as still stay in it, as long as we don't see life gain show up, but I'm sure it's right around the corner, especially after they've drawn 8 cards. Herman Jin to me, says Dreamer Stango. I haven't heard that one. Does that have to do with Pee-wee Herman, or some enunciation trick I wasn't aware of, or maybe it's a regional thing? Herman. I guess it's just a rhyming thing, eh? Bonk, bonk, bonk. All right. Very tempted to bring in that glitters on the brute there. I think I want to save that for a little surprise. Let me do here. I'm trying to stay away from spell pierce here. Now we can play the discounted price of 1 mana to draw 2 cards. That's a pretty good deal. Okay, we've got lots of stuff. I might as well bring out another guy. Oop. Let's do this. Hasted Birds of Paradise. That's why I love Springleaf Drum. Such a good card. I'll bring this out. Just powering up a really nasty glitter, so we might be able to win from out of the blue if the person gets really selfish, but it's probably not going to happen. But since Ephemerate's a thing, I'm going to not worry about my Glint Hawk here. Gingerbread's so undervalued. I just starting to see it in a lot of first place lists, that along with Ornithopter. I'm like, it's about time, guys. I've been on this list for about 5 or 6 years. Evasion is king. Having a 8-8 just smack into like tokens and kill honey garden leafs and such is gets pretty frustrating. It's nice to let it hit home, right? I didn't know that about the windy thing, mind step throw. It's pretty cool. I didn't know that either, Dreamer Stingo. Wow, look at all this knowledge being dropped in the chat. That's pretty cool, putting somebody's name in like a little MTG cipher card or something, right? All right. Boy, we're 6 minutes down. What is up with my time management? It is not good. I'm chattering too much. Too many stops. Tap out, sucker. Drop another Mold Drifter. That's what I want to see. Yeah, they're halfway through their list. Gotta have that snap 2, 3, or 4. This person knows what they're doing. That's a super good move right there. A lot of people might go for lands or, but they know what's up. Especially now that Mold Drifter's lifted its weight and gotten its ephemerate out of the way. This Caddo knows what they're doing. Maybe I've played them before. Maybe not. Yeah, problem here with other flyers, we technically don't have evasion now. I guess I go for the glitter play here. There's no familiar out. What is this familiar list? Familiars? It's just an Azorius value deck, I guess. Well, to play around the other one, let's... Actually, it works either way. I'll bring out the recruit. Alrighty. We'll go white here and leave our drums alone for the day. Bonk. I'm still going to put it on the glinty. I'll at least be able to not lose the flyer. Come over for 10. It'll probably be right back in her hand next turn. All that glitters is all that not impressive when it comes to snap and such, but it happens. Get rid of some quality. So if we get snapped, we traded all the glitters for a pretty good flyer and some tempo of having to recast it. So that sucks. Don't have it. Don't have it. You know they got it. If that Chancery taps, they've got it. Now they want to pay like 1 for it. Or maybe they go and find it. All right, this is Familiars. I just don't remember seeing the Sunscape before. I so didn't believe in this deck when it was first out. Yep. I'm talking like way long ago when people were using it and like the Nightscape Familiar to, you know, what's the Temporal Fissure and all that, you know, the old band cards and stuff. There were some incredibly cloud post decks and stuff back in the day. Yeah, once it got figured out, it was brutal. All right, this suggests that they've got the wizard to get back these snaps or everything else for that matter. So I'm just getting, we triple mulligan, now we're just getting outvalued. So Propaganda, a long time ago, a galaxy far, far away. I'm not quite sure. I know it's a Star Wars reference, but. Here comes the life. This is the kind of turn I wanted back when we were hoping to just drop that Ginger Brute before it got smashed to dust. Dust to dust. I've seen worse. We'll do this. Draw some options. Well, I really like this here. We bring out a Bodyguard first. I believe we can cast our whole hand. We'll go white here. This is just going to run into a wall, so I might as well use it for mana. Bring back our artifact. Yes. Oop, there we go. This one, please. Play land for turn. We'll do this and this for white. Boop, boop. Play this. There we go. Nice big old defender. And I guess we'll use this for white. See how colorful this list can be? That's why your sideboard can have every color in it. I love holdout settlement and what's the other one? Battlements, something. Exact same card. Thanks a lot, Bodyguard. It would have been nice for you to show up about 9 turns ago. Might have been able to shut the door. This is exactly like the other game, right? Of course, the other game we had maximum mana and we got him like 2 life. This one, it looks like this is the stalling point. Now they're going to start. The Pharaoh is going to come back. There's just too many cards drawn by now to be hopeful and say like, oh, maybe they don't have it. We have seen all our 3 snaps. Different artwork too. That's strange. Survivor's Encampment. That's the one. Thank you for that, Mystep. I have tried to make Scare Teller work so much. Never can. Always is like, kind of like that deck I've been working on where it's, you know, it's like, why not just play Black Burn? It's better, you know, I'm trying to come up with something new, you know. All right, they get back. Was that Snap? I think it was. Nope, it was not Snap. I better look to see what it was. Oh, Ghostly Flicker. Even worse. About to scoop here. When I say about, I mean now. This is hopeless. Infinite life, infinite cards, infinite options. That's not how I wanted to start. Let's just jump into another one here, and hopefully we can turn the ship around. Heyo! And not the same person. Hopefully. All right, first time chat from Dois Motivo. Hello from Brazil. I'm trying to build a slight competitive Zubera deck with Exhum and Troll. Do you think that it can be playable in the LGS? Ooh. For sure, in an LGS, there's some pretty respectable Zubera lists I've seen. My advice would be to just, you know, find an old competitive 501, build off of that, and adjust very slowly. Those decks can, a lot of practice needed in those, so hopefully you've got that already in. We'll say yes to this. Boom, 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 boom. I like this hand a lot. I've got protection for our glitters. We'll keep. Oh, Dreamer's Tangle. Yeah, that deck definitely has legs in this format. I know what to do first here. I'm going to lead with Scourge, actually. Let me do that. I'll get the aggro going here. We'll settle up with Drum and hold out right behind it. Now, any Ephemerate Mold Drifter style list is very competitive. Those things get out of control really, really quick. Of course. Now, our bodyguards are looking much less bodyguardy. If that's even a word. Don't believe it is. Because about the only thing we're going to be protecting is from... I kind of whiffed on that one, didn't I? Yeah, I guess we got to go white here. And then we'll use the bodyguard for more white mana. Because the only thing we're really going to be protected against is Journey to Nowhere. And at that point, all the glitters is kind of wasted anyway, so... But it's good for a combat trick. I sure wish they would reprint Bodyguard, but just say target creature gains protection. That would be so killer. Like, you know, when they're ephemerating their own guys or something, you'd be like, see ya, sacrifice, boom, good times. Well, that glitter's gonna be a 5/5, I believe. These are getting irritating. Powering through all this. Huh. I think I might block this. Just to throw them off the trail a little bit. That will give them a flying option, but I don't want them to be gaining too much life. We've already got a bodyguard, and I've already suggested that it's not that great of a card in this matchup. Well, it's an artifact. I'll take it. Let's actually bring out a bodyguard. So we've got another. And then we have another white source in our holdout settlement. And we'll max this out and hope they just don't have Journey. We'll tap this. Playing here. And now it's even bigger. Woo! We'll gain some life now. Take that. It's scary to play Scourge in a metagame with so many lava darts and such, but not. I think with all that glitters, it's superior to Flare Husk. I love me some Flare Husk, but okay. Well, if they had Journey, they would have played it. So we've got a little bit of a window here. Already showing that I'm willing to trade Bodyguards. These are our last two. We only run three main. I like this. We've got a human and a non-human, so we'll pay one and draw two cards. Gotta love unfair magic. All right, did I say unfair? I meant super unfair. We'll do it again. Okay, I'll do it again. You ever like drawing seven cards in your turn? It's not too helpful when they're all just draw cards. All right, we'll do it again. That's why my son loves this list. Cool. We'll play some creatures. Drew nine cards. Not too bad. Good grief. Can my window shut? Oh, they're just moving a lot of stuff over there. Got these nice blackout curtains, but they're not black enough. I think I like Inspector here just for the body and obviously the artifact. That Suture Priest is getting very irritating. Yo, dog, I hear you like card draws. That's right, Mind Stab. Sometimes it sucks when all you do is draw more cards to say draw cards. I know Boros Kitty, the old original list, ran into that issue. Player Turbo Kitty 3000. I haven't seen him in years, but he was the very first one to make Boros work. And then he got a little too greedy, and so did other players, where it was just... he kind of laughed when they were drawing cards. You're like, okay, have fun. All you're doing is drawing cards that say draw cards. But eventually you hit. Those are turns that you wouldn't have otherwise. All right. Getting a little scared of an Anthem effect here, which we know they've all got. There's usually one Ramosian Rally main and then the all the others. This is very similar to my weenie list. Always respectable. I mean, we're hitting them eight every turn and they're surviving. Griffin MTG in the house. Good to see ya. Back come the birdies. There comes the life. 8-8 Volt Scourge is usually scary, but not against this. I'm just glad we're gaining life because we'll be able to survive an Anthem or two. Maybe not much more than that. Okay, let's draw some more cards. Yeah. I really want another Glitters for that Ginger Brute. That's going to be our, what's the word? That's just going to be our saving grace. I think that's going to be what actually wins us the game. Let me do this to this, the Germans. Here we go. Boop. I'll drop that. Okay. I know they're gaining life when I do this. There's just a certain point I gotta hit here. I'm actually going to play the Brute now and not attack with it. Getting that Vault Scourge nice and fat. I'll come over. You know what? I'm cool with trading a Bodyguard. Let's try that. I'll keep the other Bodyguard back. Again, Journey to Nowhere's really nasty against us. It's almost not even worth using the Bodyguard. We lose two cards for their one just to keep a Vault Scourge on the board. Okay, boy, are we know what we're going to bring in, right? End the festivities, all three of them, big time. Hopefully they don't have defensive answers. It's incredibly obvious. But, you know, we haven't technically, if you look closely, we are playing all colors, but we haven't shown any other colors other than Azorius, so it might keep the subterfuge up. Dreamer Stingo. There's a lot of Anthem effects that already do that, just to all creatures. You could argue that might even be a little bit better. All that glitters. Please hit my Brute. Well, there's some more. I don't think I have to worry about Wraths, so I'm going to bring out the Brute. I'm going to bring this dude out. I could have paid black for that. Sometimes I forget that. Let's make this unblockable. And unblockable. And attack. Now we're going to start getting some benefits of all these critters. There's a... Guardian's Pledge works on artifacts too, though. Why do you want it to be so specific to that? There's that Aether Mage that has Flash. It's Azorius, and it says, you know, I think it says, like, till the end of turn, artifact creatures can't be dealt damage or something. That's pretty badass. I'm cool with this trade. I guess I could say pro white. Keep our dude alive. Let's try that. Just keep the aggro up. Again, I'm not worried about Journey to Nowhere. I will not use it on a Vault Scourge with all that glitters. It's just not going to happen. Like this trade. Get him to 5. That's progress. Oh, you're right, Dreamsting. I apologize. I thought it just said all creatures. I'm kind of glad when I'm wrong about a card. I have a little bit too much room in my brain devoted to this game. Squadron Hawk showing up. They're going to have to start making some hard sacrifices. We've drawn 10 cards extra off of our blue spells. Only found one, all that glitters. I think this is one of those just all-in-life swarm decks, and they're not even running Journey. Similar to what we're doing. It's just get there first. Block it. Do stuff. That's the one. Aether Sworn Shield Mage. Thank you, Pangolin Wrangler. That is one weird creature, the pangolin. Not helpful. Let's load up our dudes here. Bloop. Yes. Oh, I hate when it does that. It's like, come on. Haste it. Oh, that time it works? Not going to ask me then. Yeah, I don't think so either, Dreamstango. It is a neat option, though. I'm just going to play it for the extra artifact here. Plus, it's a nice blocking body for those bird tokens. Yep, they gain 3 life. Probably going to have to say bye to our Ardent Recruit if they do the same plan as last time. Bonk, 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 bonk. I'm willing to trade this dude. Let's go. Less people in the sky, the more my Vault Scourge gets through. Just that one, eh? All right. I gain 14 life. I gain 1. It feels like we can withstand a few Anthem effects. All right. We know what we're bringing in. WWW. White Weenie and a win. All the festivities are coming in here. I don't believe we're going to lean on strands too much, and I do not want these bodyguards showing up. They have journeys. Does that make sense to everybody? I don't think that's worth it. Yeah, let's rock. Yeah. Shield Mage is one of those cards, you know, you always start there, right? And then you, like you just said, you end up taking it out of the list. Or the Glass Dusk Hulk, I think, that's another one. It looks like, whoa, wow, and then it's just cumbersome. I know, Mindstap Thrall. The deck knows this is a good land count here because we've got kind of lands for the first 3 turns if you count the Glint Hawk effect. Whoa, keep it. Because of that, I'm going to lean on, I believe I'll lean on Inspector first. What do we get? Oh, we got a drum. All right. This is curious. We've got a really fun turn next turn. Yeah, let's... I don't like Gingerbrute too early because if defenses get up, you know, he's kind of a nothing creature. Whereas the Inspector promotes our... explosion into artifacts, and it's for this list, it's pretty hard to block it. That two toughness is big when, you know, all they have is 1/1. So I don't want to be, in other words, I don't want to be investing a mana every turn to get in with a ginger boot for one at this stage of the game. Love that card. The Great Sword of Tyr is one of those cards it always impresses you. I always want to cut it, and then in games, I'm like, damn, that does a lot. I put it in Wide Infect for a while, and the purist in me just got rid of it, but sometimes I wonder. Yeah, we're flooded now, Dreamer Stango. All right, we'll do this. We'll play here. I guess we're going to bring back... we could bring back just both our lands if we need to. Yep. And we got plenty of lands here. I'd rather have the accelerants before all hell breaks loose with you know what. Might consider the token here. I'm actually going to just bring back the land. Like I said, we have plenty of land with that Springleaf Drum. Every creature we play is a Bird of Paradise with haste, so. And Glitters hasn't shown up yet, nor has Thoughtcast. We're only like one or two plays away from making that work. Oh, that's a good point, Dreamer Stingo. Don't like seeing that. Two toughness critter. Kind of blows. All right. I don't know why he did that in the order that they did. All right. Let's get nasty. We'll bring this out here. Boop. We'll bring out another one. Again, want to save those ginger brutes for pain. Probably just Inspector Brute swing with the Inspector triggering the Brute next turn. Got a pretty mean board already. Our opponent's a little slow to develop with these steps. Yeah, so often when you're brewing, you know, like we were just talking about with the Aether Sworn, whatever, and cards feel underwhelming when you truly look at them, and get past the stats. But Greatsword's one of those rare ones when you play it, you're like, holy cow, that did a lot for that game. Okay, it's not often I need to read a card, but I do need to read this one. Dinosaur. I already don't like it. Stubhorn, 0/3, Ascend, 10 or more permanents, 3/0 as long as you have... Boy, that's a lot of work for a 3/3. Why not just play an Ardent Recruit, right? Tap target creature. Still don't need no bodyguard. I got plenty of ground crew to get in the way of that Inspector. I think they're diversifying a little too much here. It's like, are you a life deck or are you trying to be aggro? It's like kind of, pick a lane sort of thing. Oh, might as well tap that. We'll bring out, I'm still going to lean on Inspector here. We'll get a little artifact here. Let's keep Inspector back. That Greatsword gets to about, well, I don't know. I might want to start blocking pretty soon. You got to get to the end of the game, Bacon Master. I don't like it. I don't think it does enough. A whole lot of things got to go right. You got to wait forever. There's a lot of 1-mana 3/3 options. Not a lot, but they do exist. We're playing 4 of them. It's immediate. Because once you hit 10 permanents, you get... Oh, there we go. We don't really... I guess the Sun Chaser is what he's going to grab here. Okay, so they do have Journeys. No, I get the City's Blessing thing. Just kind of clunky. Watch, they just dominate us this game. Sun Chaser down! Yeah, I better start blocking here pretty soon. I'll throw this in front of the dinosaur. course, we only have one more human. We got to be careful if we do draw into our of one minds. Keep that other inspector back. All right. Shoot. I guess we inspect again. We brute squad, and then we'll use the sick inspector to put the brute squad on the mend. Haste. Yeah. Attack. Roar. We're taking six next turn. If they have an anthem effect, I think they just win here. We win next turn or they win next turn. Let's see. They've got enough mana for the anthem. That'll be a first for me, being killed by a Stubhorn Sentry if they do have the anthem. And company. Can't just give it all the credit. Woo! We got some fun little commercial breaks as I get some more coffee right after this. Uh-oh. I think they're aiming at the wrong beast, but all right. I shouldn't even say this publicly, but... like the other... Oh, that's out of the blue. Oh, interesting. Maybe they... I can't imagine why you would bring that. That card's gotten so much worse because of fume effects. Just, you know, -1/1. It's not really damage outside of Pestilence or Crypt Rat. Maybe our opponent's colorblind and they meant that to be a Crimson Alkalite. Boy, if we draw our one mana killer, that would be pretty nice right now. But all right. We get there. I'm really curious what we're going to draw next. Well, that would have drawn us about that many, and then we could have tripped that. All right, good times. 1-1. I'm going to go get some coffee, and I suggest you do the same, unless you're of the non-caffeine persuasion. We'll be right back right after this cool little thing about damage and prevention, I believe, or disruption.
Welcome to Sideboards Explored, Disruption and Prevention. Duress goes a long ways towards ruining your opponent's game plans on the very first turn. At worst, you get free intel on your opponent's hand strength. Okiba Gang Shinobi. This is the card your opponent never wants to see. If left unanswered, it can turn the tide of battle if not dealt with immediately. Flaring Pain is the only answer outside of a counterspell for some of the most powerful fog effects Popper has in its arsenal. Dispel is an all-star in a format where almost every deck has instant tricks that you'll be happy you can stop with this gem. Hydro Blast and Pyroblast are fantastic catch-all options when facing off against enemy colors. You have access to 8 of these in the form of blue elemental and red elemental blasts, but be careful, as the elemental blasts are not as flexible as Hydro Blast and Pyroblast are. Moment's Peace often feels like multiple time walk effects on the battlefield. Do not underestimate the power of fog. Curfew punishes players for going all in on a creature, especially good versus heroic decks and hexproof. Prismatic Strands often acts as a one-sided Wrath of God, but a more common use is simply to prevent damage. Obviously good versus big red spells like Rolling Thunder or Fling, its ability to flash back makes the power of this card border on being absurd. Cleansing Wildfire is a flexible answer to Tron and Karoo lands, simultaneously providing card advantage and ramp when targeting your own indestructible lands. Relic of Progenitus is a necessary evil in many sideboards and metagames. Remember, you can trip this while your own graveyard recursion spells are on the stack. For example, a Raven's Cry, buying you a card and saving your own graveyard synergy. Stormbound Geist is a superb option for blue mages in both Mirror as well as when facing off against heavy removal style decks. Lumethred Field is nasty tech for decks that aim to go wide by playing a lot of little creatures. The majority of mass removal comes in black and red, and aside from early discard, once this sticks, it's almost impossible for black or red mages to remove it. Also in this vein are Spider Silk Armor and Goblin Caves. Standard Bearer can be gruesome versus decks like Stompy, Elves, Hexproof, etc.
I'm going to cut that and come right into the game here. I'm mulligan 1. And let's see what I want to do here. I believe I'm just going to drum here. We've got a Sun Chaser Glint next turn, so that'll be good times. Yeah, Tangle in the right deck is right up there with Moment's Peace. Just that flashback ability's optimal. All right. Must have had that bump my forehead or something. All right, here we go. These aren't going to live very long, are they? Darn red mages. We get a human out of the deal. We'll do this. Doodaloop. I'm not quite sure if I want to... You know what? I'm going to actually do a ginger brute here. That way we get maximum mana next turn. We do lose on one power. Meaning, like, we're probably not going to hit a land drop, so I use Glinthawk like a cheap Skyfisher, being able to, you know, have four mana next turn instead of just the two or the three. It's hard to do the math with drum. No, it isn't. You just add one. When you start bouncing things and one equals two and two is sometimes three, the deck can get pretty fun. I guess I'm just going to write Boros for now. Bum, bum, bum. Hopefully they just have a Gal Blast and they are waiting to kill this so that we can of one mind in enough time. Ouch. I guess they didn't have to wait. There goes our human. No. Where's our bodyguards now? I'm a little late for a bodyguard now. And we can still have one mine this turn. Play the hawk, replay the den. Tap, tap, tap. Or that. Yeah. Clunky. Very clunky. Yes. It's also game two and three against a, you know, dust to dust style opponent. You can, sometimes it's, this is the correct play for a lot of other reasons, meaning, you know, you can keep your white mana source back. It's just fun being able to do stuff with your creatures. Man, really need a human here. So we come in for a whopping one, supposed to be four this turn. Bacon Master says, I'd love to see you try a league sometime. I don't know often, but it would be cool. Yeah, I don't get to leagues very often. When I used to play two or three a day for years. Tron's what got me out of the game. I just got so tired of what we saw in round one with the, you know, the flicker combos and stuff. If I was on the Pauper board, that would be the first thing I'd want to get rid of. I think Pauper's really healthy right now, except that can get... You know, you can argue that's the benefits you get for the investment, right? You're able to hold on and live, and then you get this overwhelming advantage. It's up there with, you know, why they stopped printing land destruction and stuff. People want to be able to do things, and when it's just completely hopeless. I mean, I like some combos, but that one, I guess the main reason I don't like that so much is because you can throw everything at it, have like four relics, four fairy macabres, and it's still often not enough. Very often, not enough. Just because you don't see it all that often anymore, it's still just super, super burly. And I play leagues once in a while. But yeah, I haven't 5-0'd in a long time. A lot of 4-1s, a lot of 3-2s, a lot of 2-3s, little experiments and such. Let's see, I'm not going to be attacking, so I might as well start drawing some stuff. And actually, some of the leagues we did play actually didn't have that very, very good of numbers. It's how it started. The first quite a few times with Propaganda, I would I'd always play leagues, and then we started getting spied on, and because we had such a consistent schedule, people were letting me know that. So this is all old news. But actually, my numbers went way up, and sort of the creativity of what we run into and stuff, because, you know, a lot of people do that, and trying to just be more of a community based thing. So Insomniac Images, good to see ya. Outside of running into once in a while some super jank builds, but you know, they usually will at least spur a question of like, what about this? Isn't this funny? Our opponent's probably on like 20, 21 lands, and we're on 13 and we're flooded and they're screwed. That mountain looks pretty good like that. That little red border really does a lot for that, you know, stark artwork. Oh, what do they have? Just a bunch of Gal Blasts? I mean, they'd be using them on the Hawk if that was the case. Ah, dang, these Skyfishers. Too much critter. We need a bodyguard and a glitter to show up. Do I lose the whole team to a bolt? I do not. at least want a bodyguard to make a decision like that. All right, like this a lot. Play the din. Play the thought cast. Let's find something good, shall we? Maybe like a glitters. All right, we'll do this. We'll do this. Yep. Want to get in for some damage here. We'll do the brute dance. Give it haste. Do we have another mana? For some reason, I thought it was going to let us play that. I ain't blocking with that anytime soon. Let's bring out another brute. If glitter shows up now, good times. They've only got 17 turns left. Look at that carnage. Yikes. Still not sure if I took this to a tournament. I had a lot of 5-0s with the original Brute Squad. But in full disclosure, that was before the cannonade and like breath weapons were out there and stuff, which easy to fight against in turn 2 and 3, but you do have to have it. But anyway, had a bunch of those. And so I don't know if I was to take this into a big Sunday challenge or something, I might go with my original build over the glitters move. Hunger of the new. Yeah, I do have a black brute build, but the problem with it is you eliminate blue, so you go with Deadly Dispute and that sort of package, and you end up taking away too many of your resources. I mean, there's only 4 Ornithopters in the list, and oftentimes that's what you want to be enchanting with these effects, but it's a neat balance, that's for sure. Alrighty. We are just not doing anything. We keep just drawing fluff here. All right, that really hurts. Of course, their development's really stagnant at this point. Scourge. All right. I'm going to draw some cards here. Draw some more cards. Bodyguard. Nice of you to show up. We'll play a basic here. Drop a plane. Now we've got insurance for glitters. I can save a brute. Not too worried about that inspector or whatever it's called. We'll do the thing here, tapping this, making this unblockable. Haste. Who knows, maybe I'm running with both, right? Kind of a run, shoot a black burn and build up my life. Oh, that's funny how sensitive the robot is here. Offshoot a black and just build up my life blood token still. I can make an opening hand hit for lethal with it. Which deck are you referring to? Did I lose it in chat? Sorry about that, Insomniac Images. Boop, here we go. Coming over for 4. Making things even. I really want to pitch an artifact here. Really? All right, well, we're only going to... And when we lose a brute... Boy, that really hinders their mana, doesn't it? Okay. Maybe this math will work. We've got flyers. We really needed that Bolt Scourge to show up here. Already played my land. Yep. All right. Boy, that was an all-in move, huh? Heck with Metalcraft. I wish there were more target creature gains infect spells in Pauper. You know, Phyresis. I gotta focus on saying that right. And the Tainted Strike, that's about it. Get these big old fatties and people gaining life, and then just boom, I win. Mind step throw. Yes, you are correct, but I will think positive. We're gonna hit a draw spell. All right, well, that's technically a draw spell. Let's do this. With my life where it is, I'm going to pay the black mana here. One of the other nice benefits of this deck. We'll do this, we'll say black. We'll go here, and we will actually just cast the imp. Didn't know you could do that, did you? Did I play a land? I did not. Well, since we have Ornithopter, I'm gonna tap these so that we've got options for whatever we draw here. Hopefully it's something. Let's see a draw spell. Hey, see? I told y'all, you didn't believe me. Bloop. All right, we're getting some real cards. I'm about to start blocking those Skyfishers. Would be nice to of one mind into a Bodyguard and Glitter. Drop it in that order, start getting our life back, because we're just a few blasts away from getting blasted. I think going to six is a mistake here. Of course, two lightning bolts are in the yard, and deduction reasons that they've only got about a 7% chance. I'm completely making up that stat. Don't be impressed. I think we block here. Bye-bye, Thopter. Hey, Reefer Feeder. Usually a YouTube watcher. Glad I can catch you live. We are too. Glad to have you with us. I have an old acid trip list. Do you have any tips on gameplay and upgrades to the deck? Oh yeah, I've tried to make acid trip work a lot. I think my main takeaway when I focus on it is just keep it the card. Don't try to get overly abusive with it. Obviously, your Dreamstalker and Skyfishers are usually the common things, but when you start getting into, like, you know, above eight cards that interact with it, I think the deck loses power overall, and it's a big investment too. I think if you could find a way to make it go Simic, and you had more of a ramp strategy, so that or maybe even a Familiars angle, that's right off the top of my head, like, you know, where I would start doing things differently with it. Hopefully that helps. Because we all know the old one, yeah, once there's times it'll just beat you and it feels like a world beater, but there's and, you know, don't shy away from the Kenku creature too, which kind of keep you in the game, blocking Indestructible or Beer Kill card too. Hopefully that helped. Like I said, just if I had a little bit more of a wind up to get ready for that question, I might have been a little bit better. All right. Oh, what to do. First, we're going to draw some cards. Bloop. We're going to play some threats. Curious here if I want to... There's so many options. I love this deck. Boom, boom. I'll bring out the Sun Chaser. Super Blocker Supreme. Bring out our artifact. We're just doing everything, aren't we? Now then, do we glitter? We know they got the bolt, but I'd rather it hit something than our head, right? Let's keep them honest. We didn't have to pay for this, so we'll throw this on here for the obvious benefit. Do they have a bolt? They do. All right. Hey, that's better than our face. We lose that. I will attack here. Encouraging the block. Yeah, what's that saying? Lose the forest for the trees or whatever. And so many times that happens in deck design where you can just get so hung up on something. One of the best things you can do is everybody has their favorite lists and their, you know, oh my God, this is the deck for me, blah, blah, blah. It's when you can, I guess it's kind of like an old marriage or something. you come back to it and you observe it when you're a little less passionate about it and you see things very clearly. Sometimes I'll brush off old lists and I don't have a horse in the race. I'm just like, and I really see things super clear. I'm just like, why was I playing that? You know? Hi, I want to offer promotion for your channel. Is that a bot? Yeah. Let's block that if you can, Shiraz. I mean, moving forward. It's a close game, 12-8. I definitely have air superiority. God, where's our bodyguards? I haven't seen one, and we're halfway through our list. Okay, I'm going to play it that way, huh? Somebody's got a gal blast. I got to respect it. Yeah, we're probably losing this one. I don't want to die to a galvanic blast. Misguided rage, something about sacrificing a permanent, isn't it? What do we have here? Improvised club. Targeting my cool sky lady. All right. Well, it wasn't galvanic blast, but it was the same damage. Just twice as expensive. Something good, drop. Oh, boy. That drum draws are really a backbreaker here. We are just so dead here. I'm going to play the den because they know we have it. I'm not going to block. We just got to hope that they're drawing as bad as we are right now. Man, we are flooded. Maybe I should go down to like 9 lands. Damn. I'm about to write the dreaded L on my sheet. And like the little squeef avatar up there. Going up to 10. We're going down to 4. Probably going to be met with a galvanic blast to the nose. Yeah, do see a lot more flame slash. Okay, they definitely are a little wary. Trying to put them on something. Just lands? All right, let's find a thought cast here. Of one mind, a thought cast into some good stuff. Another 3-3 flyer. 3-3 flyer. Putting it out there. All right. Well, it's a blocker. And I can pay black here pretty easily. Bloop. I'll do this to this to this. We'll keep a little mystery card in our hand. Make them think that we've got prismatic or something. I like Fissure. Instant speed. Kill a creature. It costs 5. It's so old school. That used to be one of the best red removal spells when you were, you know, right around 94, 95-ish. You double block here, and then you lose the entire team if they have anything. I'm just going to take this. Everything's a bad move at this point. We just... I got removal. We're dead. Yep. Boink. L. All right. Game 2. We see what their plan is. Look at all this red. So we've got a pretty good plan against that. Be nice if our bodyguard showed up, right? We were almost exactly halfway through our list. So all of these are coming in. I'm going to lose one glitter, a brute. A lot of flyers. I want to be focused on flyers. I'll lose another brute. Just want to see those late. 2 mana up, 1 bodyguard. Ay, 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 ay. 1 inspector. Let's go. Very predictable game one. Yes. Bloop. Bloop. I think we have to ship this, guys. Yeah, Scourge does seem bad, but we can pay the mana for it, as we did last game. And if Glitter sticks, it's just... like, game's over. One mulligan here. All right, we'll keep this because of the Vault Scourge, because we can play Recruit. This is when you just love colorless creatures. This deck favors white mana. It needs both, but you have to spend a lot of time learning what to keep with this style build. We'll keep this. Get rid of a Thought Cast. Two more of them, after all. We're quite a ways from shooting those down. We can't do a turn one Ardent. We have to go with the Vault Scourge here. All right, we'll lead off into Scourge Country here. Bloop. I probably brought in some Dust to Dusts. I'm not too worried about that. Our holdout settlements used to keep things from going south. There's part of the plan. Almost at Metalcraft. All right. Change of plans. Let's power this lady out. Where is he getting this white mana from? Oh boy, we feel vulnerable. Naked and vulnerable. What's this? Ouch. What a draw. Wow. Now we're really screwed. We need a plane or an artifact creature. Otherwise, our recruit's never going to show up. Yeah, casting a fire. We did pick that card for being like a good card and all, but my God, I had no idea it was going to be that good or see that much play. It's same with the Dawnbringer. It was like, yeah, it's a good card, and it's just like, oh my God. Love Gingerboot here. We're back in it. We'll be able to power out Gingerboot, tap to the recruit, and hold up Blue Blast. But again, you know, we haven't done any damage yet. This is just like build. Now, if they hit us with Dust to Dust, this is going to be pretty brutal. We can build back, though. Very curious what their land count is. They seem to really be struggling early and often on all their land, but maybe that's just another tempo play. I'm not sure. 1-1 so far. Anybody got a good name for when I do play somebody in the I'm going to lean on Scourge here. When I do play somebody and have the game recorded in the community, just I'm not going to do it all that often, but I did have just an epic fun game with somebody last night. But I'm looking for a good name for it. Like, you know, I don't know, Popper Game, maybe just the date or something. Something that piques a little bit of interest. Could do a lot of things here, but I'm going to stay back on Blast to protect our investments. So it was a one-on-one match. It was just really epic. It went so long. I had like 2 minutes left on the clock, and it was just one of those things. Okay, that's a very smart play. We do have the answer this time. I'm totally lost in the chat, so you guys do your own thing. I'm sorry. All right, let's find some more blue defensive cards here. Here we go. Drum, I hardly knew ya. Let's bring you out. Let's do this. Gingerbrute. Yeah, let's rock. I'll probably eat these cookies in another turn or three, but for right now, we're just going to swing for six. Click. Clark Kent Shaman at this stage. Only take out the ginger boots. Already seeing two cast into fires. I don't know how deep they go here. Now a dust to dust is pretty useless. I guess the best pull would maybe be a, you know, brute scourge combo. Leave the lions alone. Especially with my kind of curve. We're talking about burn. Don't worry about us. I'm often surprised people don't give Clark Kent Shaman flying. It's like, he stays around. I like to do it. My zero list with the Cliffhaven Wings, I think it's called. Might have that card backwards. Ooh, I like this. Red's tapped out. All right. All right, so they've got a lot of Galvanic Blast mana here. I think it's better to just stay back. God, I would love to draw Glitters right now. That would really shut the door. Even if they have a next turn answer for it, just totally reset our life here. Oh, have to blow up huge creatures in a burn deck. I see. Well, ask and you shall receive, right? Here we go. I'll say white. Boink. Let's go. Yeah. We will gain all our life back. And you will submit. Crunch. It's probably a journey or double gal blast or something, but the point is, we're back and healthy. We've got two ginger brutes. They're at two life. This looks rough. I think we're going to game three. Could be very wrong, though. But even here, right, a prismatic strand almost does nothing. Ginger brutes are still going to get through. And do you call black, and then you still get hit with the recruit. I like this a lot. I was really afraid that was a dust to dust, because at that stage that would be really good. But not for our lands, as you would think when you first bring these in. Down goes the recruit. All right. Wrong target, my friend. All right. We pull even. We go to game three, which I like because we didn't show too much of our sideboard off. They just saw one blue blast. We really go pretty hard in the paint with those. I think the three glitters is the right call. Yeah. We got a little maroon there early, if you remember, with our... Thank goodness we have... You know, we've got the Scourge, the Brute, and the Thopter. You don't want to skimp too much more, because if you get a blue heavy draw, you can't get into white without the help of those via the Springleaf Drum or the Holdout Settlement. So we're just going to run it back, guys. Alrighty. This is good. Definitely seen better. This is all right. Yeah. Oh, what to see. If they lead off with just a white source, I think we can go into Scourge early. We'll keep. It's weird, but we'll get there. Still have to, you know, those casting of fires are brutal. All right, change of plan. We'll lead off with a drum. Come on, drum. I think I'll lead off with another drum next turn. We'll have Recruit take the brunt of removal. Sometimes I wish I could play Glasses of Urza. I mean, I guess you can play it. You just have to put it in your deck, right? But play Optimal Magic every turn. Hey, what do you got? Always been tempted to play that card. Alrighty. We have a lot of mana now. Bring out the drum. We'll bring out a brute. We'll bring out a recruit. Now, what I'm worried about here is a casting of fire. So you could do the same thing and both these would die. However, if I do play that Scourge for two life, something will live. So let's do that. Feels a little reckless, wanton, whatever verbiage you like to use, but I think that's the right play. I love those this and then that. My favorite is, what is it? Dominus, it's the is it one, like makes it unblockable and plus +1/+1 and shroud for one blue or red. That's awesome. Used to play that in my blue blitz lists. A lot of fun. All right. They've only got one option here. Nope, they have two. Keeping up red. I see ya. I don't know why you would use that as it. Oh, I guess they're afraid of glitters here. Cloud of Dominus or Dominus or however you say it. Yeah. Good times. Alrighty. Well, we definitely have enough artifacts to pull this off, so let's maybe we can find a land here. We're not going to be attacking with you, Mr. Brute. Land's a little too precious right now. We will draw. Yay! We can do stuff. But before we do stuff, I'm going to attack because Recruit will probably be met with a Bolt, which I almost want at this stage. Yeah, I love that card. You know, it's funny. Frostborn Weird is never seeing play. That used to be a mainstay, like a 1/4, and you can pump it either way. That used to be a thing. All right, we'll bring this out. I think we can bring out everything, right? Have we played a land this turn? We have. Darn it. White, this. White, this. Bring out this. Bloop. In the old days of Brute Squad, I used to power out the Glint Hawk. Activate the Tooth of Chisgora, return the Tooth of Chisgora, play it again. It's like a lot of fun little interactions there, but really torn on kind of the optimization of this. Oh, good patience on our opponent's part there. I've got quite a bit of critters here, representing some pretty good damage. Damn sun didn't shut his door correctly, so the wind. We live near the ocean, and it's incredibly windy after about noon on, and it's here very early today. It's a cold one. Comes right off the ocean. That Pacific gets very, very cold. You always hear about LA having, you know, heat, but we're technically not in LA. We're very coastal. So we get the fog, and I love it. It's the only reason I can live in LA. Makes me feel like I live in northern Washington or London or something, because it's most of our summers are just dark, 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 dark. All right, they're taking away our air superiority. It's costing them a bit. All right. Well, we got 4 damage a turn. Glitters now would be another fun pull. They're doing the math. Okay. Let's make them unblockable with haste. Come over with a very unexceptionable play. Blop, blop. Attack, attack. I'm just going to exhaust here. Let's bring this back. This will return a drum, maybe. Actually, technically, if they go crazy and had some amazing hand, it's probably best to bring back Ginger Brute. Technically can sacrifice him for life here, thanks to Springleaf Drum and Company. All right, let's go. Yeah, I really expected a little bit more upheaval from the results, the challenges, things kind of staying the same. Don't like Seeker. That's a lot of life. But Ginger Brute's very good against it. As you block it, it's a 4/4 life gain. Then you gain 3 life. They don't gain any. You swing again. I like him tapping out here. Really want to draw glitters now. Let's go of one mind into glitters. Let's put that thought into the universe, right? Been trying to think a lot more positively lately. It's strange how often that seems to work. Ooh, gotta watch my time. Y'all didn't warn me. This is game 3, though. Let's go. I got plenty of time. of one mind, and it glitters. Come on, we can do this. Y'all thought I was making that up, didn't you? Oh, hold on. Ah, man, I want everything to work here. I'm going to actually tap the scourge. Our life isn't that low here. I think it was right here. Glitters. I think I may have made a few more fans of the whole think positive movement, right? That's pretty creepy when that happens. We'll put this on here. I call it of one mind and the glitters. It happened. That's how we roll. Let's just make this unblockable. Yep. I'm going to attack with everything. They want that seeker to get big. That's fine. Attack. I ain't blocking him. Change of plans. Bonk. Let's go. Propaganda hype. Thank y'all. Okay, that bodes well. 4. Tough scenario. You want to gain the life of Seeker, but you need the blocker. Probably saying bye to Ginger Boot. Artifact removal. A lot of things can take it down. Journey 2. That's an option, but the creature still stays around. All right. What shall we call next? I already have a Ginger Boot. I like that. I don't really have too much. Another Glitters. There's only 2 left and 44 cards. I think it's probably better we call Thoughtcast. All right. Down he goes. 3 life back. Maybe some more. We'll see. What do we got? Oh, the 1-1. Oh, man, I was really... Man, if that was a cast into fire, that would have been brutal. Again, 5 life. We just completely nix our board. Yowza. 4 life coming back. That sucks. This is a tough decision. I wish I could see their hand. Memory glasses, Verza. Hey, almost the same. Alrighty, I'll do the of one mind here. We don't have a human, do we? Yikes. Pay 2. Okay, I've paid 2. Let's go. Yeah. All right. It helped a little bit. We can't gain a life, can we? All right, let's go white here. Hate having a kind of technically wasted turn, but it will be nice to have this out. Doing a whole lot of blocking here. Actually, cancel that. I want to probably block with Bodyguard this turn, so let's bring, oh wait, shoot, I can't do that. I did that in the wrong order. I should have brought out Brute first for what I was planning to do here. Cancel. My time is running out. Blue, let's go. Bloop. Here we go. All right, I guess I can make that pro black, right? You know what? Let's power out the rest of the guys here. Bloop, blop, bing, pow. Rolling the dice. A little too reliant on that bodyguard. This is when I do miss Flare Husk for just those blah blocks. Now we care a little bit too much about a lot of our creatures. Their quality is getting too high. Oh, when would that not be handy? Dreamer Stango. That'd be a funny instant. Super handy. Just show some like dwarven like appliance worker or like a handyman. Two and a half to nine and a half. Where did the time go? Okay. I think we'll just be protecting that. Got to watch my time here. The plan right now is to block Seeker with Scourge and pro-wide it. Prevent all this hideous life gain. A Ric Flair husk. That's awesome. Mind step. Throw with the comment of the day. And put a Woo token into play. What would a Woo token do? It would have to like encourage, you know, the rest of everybody. So it'd be like sort of an anthem effect, like all creatures get one, all your creatures get 1-0 until the end of turn, sort of thing. I really like this play because we can say pro white and still block our dude because he is targeting that, right? Yep. So we'll say this to here. Say pro white. And now he can't gain the life. When we gain a life, lose a creature. Of course, it did cost us two. Give me my life. Why didn't it give me my life? Oh, that's right. Huh. Felt like it should have. Got to keep one of these dudes back. So let's do this. Anybody know why I didn't gain life there? It's protection from white. I hit him and I stayed at 12. Should have gained one life there. Did I see that wrong? What am I doing wrong here? Oh, this is close. I think we might lose on time, though. Let's not say that, because that'll happen. We've got Ginger Brute keeping things honest. We really need the glitters again. We're even on our Thought Casts. I think we're going to roll in a Thought Cast Glitters. Uh-oh, that's real bad. That's game. That's brutal at this stage. Really need one of my blue counter spells there. That's a backbreaker. All of our creatures are gone. I'm just going to mow them all down. There goes one. We'll see what we draw. Good evening, Prostate Pirate. What a name. Yeah, we can gain some life here, but they've got us. We'll wrap this one up. Darn it. Close one, but yeah, munitions is brutal at certain times of this game. That's why we run so many anti-blue cards here. Let me go get some more coffee, and I'll be back right after these messages, everybody. Woo! Four. Let's go. Yeah. I can't say I have a coffee addiction. I quit months at a time and I never get that, you know, the headaches that people always talk about. Well, I like this hand. It's dangerous, though. I really only have one unplayable here. We are on the draw. I'll keep this. Thank you for that, Shiraz. Yeah, I almost played Prostate Pirate. I almost played that a lot of the new cards, including Hopeless Nightmare. I had a deck. It's pretty good. Just had a weird feeling it might go like 1-4 today or something, and I couldn't take that after last week's beating. Got to keep morale up, right? Okay, I think we just mirror this. Don't really know what we're up against first here, so I'll bring out another Inspector. What do we got here? Is this another Boros list? Looks to be that way. Shoot, the whole reason I got up, besides getting coffee, was I was going to fix my son's door, but oh no, is this like a pestilent build? All right. What shall we discard? Well, right now, I'll lose another one mind. Sure. Not guaranteed to hit a blue here. We lose two life. They do some stuff. It's probably like a Skyfisher Omen build, I'm guessing. Get super value out of the Hopeless Nightmare. But hey, there you go, Pirate. There's the card you wanted to see. I'll even zoom in on it for you. Bloop. Artwork's pretty cool. I might have put it in a different direction. That's just me. All right, all the glitter's showing up. Wee bit frustrating. I think we get our evasion online. Just in case they're not on removal. And we can, just drop a glitters next turn and start swinging. Who knows? We're at 16 already. How'd that happen? See, Pirate's putting a thought out into the universe, and it manifests, even through the digital ether. Isn't that something? All the cards that could be played. Of course, it is very biased. When a new set comes out, you're going to see a uptick of the newer cards that can be played. But all right, 3 mana to 1. Let's stop this Springleaf Drum even here. Be happy to see. Or another mana. That helps. Into an of one mind. That helps. I'd rather get secure here. We haven't seen a removal suite, and we're just staring down black, which I don't like. We'll bring out mana. Speak and you shall receive. The Popper Preacher. That would be a funny like YouTube channel. Let's bring out a white. Bloop. And bring out our power dude. Not too bad for one turn. Make 2 mana. Get some creatures. Attack for life. Hopefully this thing lives. Be nice to find a bodyguard next. Bodyguard glitters, pretty hard to come out of, but unless they're running the Journey. Journey is the bane of glitters. You can't really protect it. I know there's some cards that technically can do it, but they'll be losing you more games than they're helping. The Dispute. Token for a token. All right. Did I cross off the right ones? Yes, I did. Just out of curiosity, does everyone in the chat remember Arkham's Astrolabe? I went to so much trouble making that commercial. The Astrolabe warehouse, as ridiculous as that sounds, is why I liked it. And I was looking at it the other day going, I wonder if like the new breed of player or people that are just a year or two in even know what that means. There's enough other magic lore in there to kind of suggest, but I'm kind of holding a little hesitant on the glitters here. Yeah, everybody had Astrolabe and everything back in the day, right? Am I giving this guy too much credit? Are they on some cutesy build with no removal? I don't want to go all in on glitters until they're tapped out or... Let's bring another recruit. I just want to scare him here. I'll bring this out. Let's do this. I'm not going to be attacking with this guy, so I'll do this. Make this unblockable. We'll come over for 5. That's respectable. Okay, so it won't be lost on this crowd anyway. So I do have that as one of the commercials, but might not even roll to it. I'm not going to be taking many more breaks. So relaxing having a new PC and knowing that everything's going to work. Of course, last week, I accidentally had one of our spots muted. That was frustrating. What do we got here? Prismatic? What is this new devilry? Yep, Bacon Master. That's the worst, isn't it? It's like, oh, let's ban Prism next week. We'll make this new card that's even better called Energy Refractor. No ban. They just hard cast that. Okay, good to know. They're on a snuff out style. Maybe that means no journeys so that our glitters will be hitting Vault Scourge or Ginger Brute. If you're low on life, always target the Ginger Brute if you've got enough mana to trip it, because if they answer it, I think we did that in game one. They burn it in response, you gain 3 life, trip it. Might as well get something out of the Cookie Man, right? I don't like the new Gingerbread artwork. I'm not too fond of the old one. But I do like this one's superior. I just like how dark it is and that lady kind of scared in the background. So you see that lady way in the background just kind of clutching at her pearls and freaking out. My son, when he drew that for our little Pictionary series, that's what he focused on. That's what I mean. It's so hard to sometimes tell. Speaking of my boy, he's at the RCQ today. Hoping he does well there, obviously. Why do I even say something like that, right? Who wouldn't want their son to do good? Do I go for it, guys? Let's keep him honest. It's like, why didn't you do it last turn if you're going to do it this turn? I think we go here. Because this is a black creature and we've seen snuff out. And they have cast. Whoa, it worked. All right, good times. Let's make this have haste. And we'll keep up. Come over for 14. Good times. Is the recruit going to go the way of the snuff out? Will our scourge live? Find out on this week's exciting episode of Papaganda. Isn't that Geth Avatar? Thank you for the hype. So here we go, right? We got 3 colors coming at you. Guess you call black. Now they take 4 or more. Just 1 now. All right. Blop. I'm going to bring out this other. Not too worried about our life total. And seeing snuff out main really makes me want to flex on this extra scourge here. I don't seem to have too many instant options, so just want to really push the advantage here. Omen showing up, getting back Inspector. Looks like I called it. Now all we need to see is a Skyfisher to confirm my observation. So yeah, that UFC event tonight, I don't think it's worth buying. It's a bunch of people I haven't heard of. And then even Strickland, like I said, at the top of the show, I just don't think he stands a chance. Happy to be wrong. Just way too mechanical of a fighter for something like Izzy. It's just going to... Actually, if I bet on it, I would bet, like, I think Izzy's going to win the end of the second round, and I don't think he's even going to have a scratch on him. I don't think he's... I literally don't think he's going to get caught with almost anything. I think it's going to be incredibly one-sided. I like to make these predictions very bold and, like, you know, because I miss hard a lot of times, obviously, when you go that specific. But when you get it right, my friends are like, you're a fighting genius. It's like Vegas, right? They only remember the times you got it just right and not all the ones that you whiffed on. But, yeah, the main card's not that great. And then all the ones leading up, I'm like, I'll watch the prelims and Google it. Watch it on YouTube in 2 weeks or something. I guess Israel Adesanya, the champ, he's got his own movie out now. Wow. We need to go on a diet. Look at all these cookies. Might as well. We've seen strands. They're going to say black on this one, so I'll just swing over here. I'm going to get reckless. Let's go. Haste. I'm not going to be attacking with this one, so I'll tap it. Haste. Bloop. And away we go. Prismatic for black. We'll still get in with our recruit and little cookie men. These decks make me nervous. They invest so much and then they just get this insane power effect after the fact. I still haven't built with the Troll of Khazad-dûm yet. Very good card. It's nice how they're putting a lot of these mana fixers in. Another card I got very wrong was Lorien Revealed. I was like, man, that's a whole turn somebody's going to be spending. But, you know, I didn't take into effect how effective that island cycling would be. Because we've seen it before, and that wasn't played before. But I guess when you combine it with that, it's similar to, like, adventure cards, right? Where both sides of it, you're like, But, boy, you put them together, it's like, whoa, that's a lot of value. So Hopeless Nightmare with that new black instant, two and a black, some despondent dude on a horse, Rowan something, Resolve or Regret or something. Man, I saw that played against me in the Wilds of Eldraine pre-release, and I reconstructed it into the deck that I was almost going to play today, maybe next week. Won't make any promises. And had some serious card draw. Like, end of turn, I'll scry, like, twice for two, and then I'll look at four cards and put two in my hand, lose two life. It's like, damn, that's like a sixth of your deck. Yeah, I'm with you there, Pirate. That's exactly kind of how I was looking at it. I think in terms of time walk a lot, when something costs three or four mana or up, especially in Pauper, I'm like, really, you're going to take your whole turn in a counter-heavy format? Somebody can just go stop that and then boom, hit you again with something. All right. Win that one. They just didn't have enough resources, even though they were really compiling them. Saw a little bit of graveyard, saw a little bit of everything. I don't think relics really all that great here. We saw Snuff Out. Do I just roll it back? I'm going to bring in a Harsh because they might have Guardian. They might have ways of really making it nasty. Don't really think I need too many Ginger Boots here. I think I'll leave one of these out. We'll go like that. For 5 mana, draw threes and Pauper. I really like the new one that just came out. Yeah, there's that, what is it? Something study. Two and a blue, but it's an instant. It says draw two cards. It's like, that might see some play in one of those oops at the end of your turn. I got all these counters into Fate Court. Yeah. Yeah, I look at that and I'm like, there's no way, but, you know, that's why I'm often wrong about this. We love this hand. This is your just idyllic hand, right? Almost too much mana. I'd be happy to not see the seat there. But Thopter Drum with land is just barbaric in this list. You'll soon see why, unless they just have an insane, like, remove that, remove that, remove that every single turn. Can happen. Often does. Ooh-wee. All right. Sometimes there's just too many options, right? Yeah, let's save our den. Just in case they've got some turn two nastiness, right? Already got Metalcraft. I can bring out a lot of stuff here. I'm just going to represent threat immediately. We got Of One Mind next turn. I mean, this is a gorgeous hand. It's very good, too, once you've really settled on a 75 that you like and you're sticking to and you're playing over and over again. One of the last steps of really polishing a deck that a lot of people miss is write down what your optimum draw is. See, right there, I was playing to my outs there. I think you should have taken the drum there. But I'd much rather the seat go, and that's why I stuck with the den back. But anyway, finding your optimal hand, and then does your deck list support that? Like, if these are the best cards, you better have four of them. You want those in your opener, you know. Low curves, it's a little less relevant. Let's go here. We'll build up our artifact base here. We'll draw some cards. How do you do that, Mr. Deluxe? Well, you tap something that isn't useful right now until next turn, and you see if you got any creatures that aren't critters. Woo! We got all kinds of draw going on here. Man, oh man, that would have been a brutal turn if he had not sacked the seat, right? I'd just be like, draw, 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 draw. Of course, we'll just do that next turn. Again, Ornithopter stops Faye all day, stops a lot of stuff. And you're able to, you know, power it out, sacrifice it, or use it for Of One Mind and Thought Cast abilities. Mind's dead. A lot of wobbling here. Tapping creatures and such. I just wrote down Pestilence, but that's inaccurate. Maybe it is. We haven't seen anything yet. That'll thwart our attack a little bit. I'll get out a good threat here. Use it for free mana. I'll tap this for blue. Do we have enough for that? Nah, we'll just do the of one mind here. Woo! Let's go! 1, 2, 3, 4. We can do it some more. I ain't attacking with you, so let's go. Plop. Already played in. All right. Too much fun. We've only drawn 6 more cards. Even a dust to dust here. You know, you grab the drum in the den. One card away from Metalcraft again. Again, the main way to beat this list are those, you know, cannon effects and stuff. But, you know, that's why I have like 6 counters for it in the sideboard, because you know it's coming. Just hold back blue and still win usually. But when they get like 3 or 4 of them in a row, that's when you just scoop. Well, this is strange. I don't want to really favor. I'm going to get rid of the Inspector just in case they have a dust to dust. We're not out of the woods yet. No, I'll get rid of a Brute Squad. Scoop, there it is. That's pretty great. Got old ashes to ashes. All right, another nightmare showing up. It's turning into a nightmare, isn't it? All right, I will lose a settlement. Remember what I said? I was lying. He really wants that Skyfisher to return those, doesn't he? I've played Memphit quite a few times. Haven't seen them on this build, though. Like that. And that's the way it is. Huh. Let's go with this. Before I do much else, I'll attack. I'm thinking of tripping a clue here. Tripping a clue here now. Boy, these recruits are doing some work. Loving it. Really getting around Skyfisher and company. Oh, he's got a trick or something? What's going on here? Not that we can really answer that. What is this? Fimrate, okay. Into the Nightmare. Interesting. Interesting. Ooh, maybe we should have kept that Ginger Brute. These hopeless nightmares keep coming back. I won't have many turns to live here. I don't want to bring out the Vault Scourge until I get Glitters or a Bodyguard, because that's just going to be... I mean, I could pay for it right now. I think we trip Clue, drop Recruit. Yeah. Let's do this and this. Get a Clue here now. Ooh, all right. Well, if a card likes you, keep it coming. Let's go. Man, that's a lot of damage. Had I known, I would have just, well, no, we wouldn't have drawn it without the clue, so never mind. I was right! That's what I'm talking about. All right, Skyfisher, do your thing. We are going to be hurting. Going to bring back another nightmare, play both nightmares. They attack, I will block. I'm respecting this, this plan here a bit. Might be something there. Yeah, we're going to lose both our cards. That really sucks. I don't mind losing the Scourge at this stage, but you know they're going to play that other Nightmare. That really blows. I wish this was a land at this point, because having 4 recruits early. What's this, our first 18 cards? Very unlikely. And in this matchup, awesome, awesome card. A lot of times, side them out. Careful of those humans, though. Side out two humans, you might want to side out two. Well, I take that back. In this style, artifact creatures are the best. Oh, I love this play. Please don't play a nightmare. I want this recruit to drop. I respect that play a lot. Oh, they're still going to have it. Long time watcher, first time catcher of a live stream. Woo! Noel Uru. I'm sure I said that wrong somehow, but thank you for chiming in. Good to have you with us, my friend. Happy you made it. All right. This is like the 19th nightmare. Jeez, oh, piezo. It's a nightmarish list. We're even. Look at the board, and we're even. So people that think Hopeless Nightmare doesn't do too much, it's doing enough here. Oh, man, I feel bad for this guy. We got to go for it. I'll power it up on Ornithopter here. I don't want to lose any quality of creatures here. This is just a backbreaker if this sticks and he doesn't have snuff out this game. Crunch. Nightmare on Pauper Street. That'd be a pretty fun little spoof. We already did the, you know, we've got the horror festival sort of angle. But all right, into the last match here, guys. We are 2-1, right? No. We're 2-2. We lost to familiars. We got them right on the edge of death both times, which is just common occurrence for familiar style lists. We beat White Weenie and a Pestilence build. And we lost a close one to Boros. Already 200% better than last week. Like I said, you do this show long enough and often, it's about once a year we'll go completely like 0-5 and just bleh. So you just have to bounce back with something a wee bit more competitive. We love this hand. We'll keep this. This is another one of those. Is this how much you love me, baby hands? Woo! Exciting. Whoa, haven't seen that art. That is ugly. That can kind of grow on you, literally. Thopter Drum. I could even go Thopter Drum Hawk. Let's bring out Thopter first. Bring this dude out. And bring out the drum. I could go Hawk here. I think I want to, if he's got removal, I'd much rather be spent on this recruit. Next turn we'll have Metalcraft. This is the optimal damage plan and keeps our Air Force safe. Ouch! The match. All right, we won't go out that way. Let's go. Won't even count that one. Roll on over to the list here. Were they sniping the stream and heard me insult the art? Who knows? Yeah, I really wished I could have pulled this one off. This used to be main in this list. These used to be, well, they still are. I still have that build. This is Glitter Squad. Brute Squad has Flare Husks here. It has the Harsh Sustenance main. Bodyguards are gone. And there's a Journey package, I believe, of 3. Yeah. Good stuff. What do we got over here while we're waiting here? Thopterlux, Black Garden. Yeah, the Black Clock. That's the one I've been working on. Very frustrating. Keep adding lands to it. Keep stalling on that second land. It's like, come on. Monocolor list. Nothing comes into play tapped. Boy, that's some gorgeous artwork. Therese Nielsen. Woo. I know there's an event in Vegas coming up. I got to it late. It's in October. I think it's like a big magic convention. Should have gone to that. Got to take some time out of work and take my boy to those things. Of course, I just hate crowds. Yeah. Minecraft? I haven't heard of that ability. All right, we are in a queue, right? What's going on here? Yes, we are. Okay. See, I'm not quite sure. I mean, I've got Blue Brute, 2 builds of that. I've got Brute Squad, the original. Still one of my very favorite lists. This is that kind of list. They should have a little subcategory where it's just when you're feeling like down in the dumps. All right, what's going on here with this preview pane? Let's go. All right. Not the greatest hand, but we'll keep it. Let's lead off with a recruit here. Probably go Sun Chaser next. Very weird hand. If they've got early removal, this is going to be a tough, tough match. Don't be red. It's probably red. Oh, it's heroic. Good times. Probably take out all that glitters in this matchup. They've got a lot of pro effects, and I'm sure they have journeys and such. I want to get our air power here going early and often. Let's find a drum next. Artifact creature. I don't know. We need some help. A little flooded. Not the right kind of flood. We need artifact flood. We know they're on a glitter plan too here. Yeah, Stripped Riverwinder. Very underplayed card. That's a great card. Heroic is our last one here. Thanks for joining me, everybody. So you got plenty of things to do with your Saturday. It's nice to have all of you live with me. Appreciate it. There's a target. Woo! Definitely Prismatic Strands, as I write in my little notes over here. Nothing improves. We're going to Hawk Chaser. Improve. Yeah. Well, we can... Yeah, we can... We'll go Hawk Mind now. Hawk Mind. Eh, that wouldn't make a good band. Play it again. I would rather do some stuff here. Let's do this. Draw some cards. Get out of this funk. Let me get a drum. A drum, they say. Well, all right. We'll just all of a sudden be able to attack for three. Woo! I'm Wiki Bear. Vault Scourge is a hell of a card. I did a one of our many videos. I broke down outside of Infect. Infect throws the curve off. Actually, Leonin Nightmare or Dengar. What's that 2-1 with Infect? That's actually the most bang for your buck in Pauper when you're talking about big creatures. When you really add up all those, the stats and the math and how it impacts a game, if, you know, left unchecked. But Vault Scourge is like the best creature in Pauper. Everybody can run it. It has evasion and it has lifelink. I've always been a big fan of that. And boy, if red's absent of your metagame, nighty night. Uh-oh. I don't have many ways around this other than Prismatic Strands. Really miss our journey plan here. I don't have ways of pitching a air powered dude, meaning like our Ginger Brute or even our, and you know, let's find a bodyguard. Maybe we can do a really nice block strategy and at least stop them from gaining life once. They're going to be right back up at 20. Look at this. Nuts. Lost Leon, and that's it. Mind Stab Throw. Yeah, I was talking with the guys from Brute Force Games out of San Diego and Snap Bolt Country. He was doing all the analysis too, and he came up with Lost Leon and two. And he doesn't even play. He didn't know White Infect was a list. I'm like, hey, I've got a list with that. I had it right with me, too. And he was like, what? The Thalids. All right. You know, I did kind of call that again. Bring out a bodyguard. I can at least stop the bleeding a little bit. Bring this out. We shall do some stuff here with bodyguard. Bloop. And I'm not going to be attacking with you anytime soon, so let's do this. We've got lots of air power. This is when you really miss Tooth of Chisgora, when you've got these four fatties, because our Ardent Recruit is nothing more than a semi-permanent fog effect. We'll come over with this. Man, we need to find all of our bodyguards. We represent a lot of damage. They just can reset every turn now. I'm not familiar with that song, Mind Stab Throw, but I love the passion. I'm sure if you hummed it to me, I might know it. tough list to warrant bringing in. That's brutal. That's game. I've got to use bodyguard offensively now. Yeah, they've got us. I don't know if you guys can see that. Vigilance is so much more valuable these days. And when you can make the investment, Sentinel's Eyes doesn't look like much at first, but it ended the game that time. Strands, come on in. Harsh Sustenance, I can target your creature with it, and I might be able to kill it because sometimes this hits for like six or more. Might be able to pull it off. I'm just going to bring in the one, though. I don't want festivities here. Need more of an electricity effect, and even then I probably wouldn't bring it in. I think that's all we got, folks. Bodyguard's actually going to be pretty good if they you know, might buy us a turn behind some strands here. So now what to lose? I'm going to lose two brutes and an inspector and a recruit. Let's go. Those 0-4 centaurs, if those show up early, the recruit's just dead, as we saw. I might have been able to get there if we had, you know, done 9 damage with the recruit, and that darn horse man didn't show up. Oh, yeah, bodyguard's fantastic. I love it. If I was ever turned into a card, I'd want to be like, Deluxe Bodyguard, and it says any creature gets protection from... Like I said earlier in the show, it'd be so cool if somebody's trying to, like, ephemerate their own guy, and you're like, no, I will protect you. Yeah, we want to go first. I hesitate there because I often play a zero list. We like this hand a lot. We're a little artifact light, but the inspector will help us with that plan. We don't see any of our sideboard, but don't really want to. If I had, like, two prismatic right now, I'd probably ship it, if you're wondering. Woo, Dosin the Falling Leaf. Salute. What a cool name. Sound like some monk you find on the high mountains, high forest mountains or something. Or we could just lean on aggro. Let me do that. Sometimes I like to Thopter or Glentok out and just return a Thopter. Not the greatest value, but you don't lose any tempo. And hey, man, we got two flyers on turn one. That's pretty cool. That's nothing new to this channel. I've had lifts with like 4 or 5 flyers on turn one. Optimal for sure, but it does happen. Okay, I'm going to want that inspector out for a lot of reasons. The main one being that damn cat. Meow. Glitter's showing up nice and early. A little too early. Going to hold off on that. We shall do some stuff here. I'll bring out the inspector. Two artifacts now. One away from relevance. Don't want to have him gain life, but I guess we're going to let him. Damn it. Attack. If they're stuck on mana, that might be worth blocking. Are you talking to me, Bacon Master? Is that the convoke list? Or was it the... That one was awfully sneaky. It's like you're just doing all this cute stuff and looks like you're just dorking around and then boom, nighty night. I think that's the one you're talking about. I want to double check my background. There we go. Can't get my lighting quite right in the new studio, new setup, new angles. There was a little bit warmer light to the other room. Not too fond of... I'm not a very vain person, but I do have my pride. Three life. This sucks. We need to get our life gain dude on board. We've only got two artifacts so far. Vigilance. There's another boink. I still don't want a glitter right now. That has first strike. Can we do this? Oh, yeah, we do need one more, huh? Ah, that's what it's here for. Let's pay it. We might draw into something else. There it is. Now it costs one. Let's do it again. Woo! Hey-o! All right, kitty cat's going bye-bye. Of course, the Umbra's going to have something to say about that. First strike, that's a bummer. That will get rid of the Umbra, though. The cat will survive. Our sustenance. 6 damage, baby. The frequency of the ceiling fan is rattling a painting on the wall. Too late for the mic to get, but it's like the house is shivering. They're really going all in on this. Tap out. There we go. Oh, hate that. Now I gotta use harsh sustenance on that. Damn it. Ugh. Why can't they just be easy opponents? Let me just run you over. Look good on camera. Crunch. Really want one of our life gain dudes to show up, and now we can't even glitter it. Do we stay back? Sun Chaser showing up. That's pretty cool. I guess we can do all of it, right? We'll keep taking the damage here. Sun Chaser. Yep. Hawk. We'll be able to gain quite a bit of life with our harsh sustenance. I just really don't want it to, hey, what happened here? Hawk. Let's go. Did I not click it? Yes. I want to just flood the board with creatures right now so we can gain 7 life when we do kill something. Attack! It can kind of stay even with that cat, but man, I gotta kill that thing. Is this game one? No, this is game two, isn't it? We lost the first one, didn't we? Yeah, it was that huge, I'm going crazy. Yeah, that's why we have harsh sustenance in our hand, you dummy. Boy, what a maniacal avatar that is. Okay, this just keeps going. Man, it's windy outside. Uh-oh. We can still block this. Probably expecting us to have journeys, which is a very good assumption because my normal list does have it. But hey, we're here to play new cards, and all that glitters is new, and therefore I will play it. We're at that stage now. I think I'm going to start dropping some thopters here. I'll let it hit me this time. I'm going to start blocking with thopters after this. So we will be gaining quite a bit of life back here, 7 at least. Gingerbrute showing up. All right. Hey, got to use a whole lot of life here, don't we? I can't block with white. I won't be attacking with you, so I'll use it for white. I need black. Bloop. I won't be doing anything with you. And any color. Harsh sustenance showing up. They are hellbent. This is good times. Gain some life back. I really wish I could have targeted you-know-who, but we can't now because of Benevolent Blessing. I don't know if our Ginger Brute might be able to keep us in this. We're going to need to draw a lot of them, though. Let's not forget, I've got a Glitters in my hand. Sacred Cat lives up to its name with all those abilities, doesn't it? All right. Don't play a land, opponent. Don't do it. This is another Standard Bearer would be pretty brutal. They just keep gaining too much life. They got Prismatic here. We've got that too. Let's hold off. Hold off again. Harsh sustenance kind of reset my math there. Really kept us in it. Oh, Journey to Nowhere, where are you? That's a bad play. Got to keep me guessing at this stage. That just does nothing for the board. That does something for the board. Woo! Just we don't have any flying. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We could put it on Thopter. really like the ginger brute here. I'll go white. Sure. This. All right, what are we doing here, guys? Got to put it on some sort of evasion. Let's put it on this. Start making this math work in our favor a lot more. We're going to start blocking with ginger brute next turn and tripping it so that they don't gain the life. I will block with the other one for right now. There's no slouch. We're doing 14 a turn. They're gaining 5. We might be able to get there. That's not that massive. It's just very massively protected. Only a 5-5. I say massive, I'm thinking like 16-16 or higher, right? Obi-Wan, 2B21. You should run Celestial Flare to deal with those kind of matchups. Yeah, that's an option. It's a good card. Really would like to support a double white mana base. I usually favor Bodyguard block or Trigger Bodyguard or Brute block, gain 3 life. It's usually a one-swing game with glitter-style effects or prismatic. So I've already got a lot of ways. It's a little too specialized. However, that's a very valid card in a white heavy list because of all the serpent lists around and get around ward and that sort of thing. Yuck! Does that work? Oh, Spirit Link works. That's right. Life Link wouldn't. Can someone explain that in the rules? I know that's how it goes. I just I forgot about that. Does it do the damage first and then check? I think that's what happens. Or is it all at once? No, it's all at once now. Man, I'm a mess. Somebody help me. We shall block. Pretty sure, yeah, that's how Spirit Link gets around that. There we go. I like that a lot. So you can still kill them. All right. So we've got 12 in the air. I guess we glitter again here. Propaganda. Lifelink happens at the same time as the damage, whereas a Spirit Link is an after damage resolves. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I do know these things, but then I forget them. So is that knowledge? Probably not. Let's do this on here. They don't have any cards in their hand. So I think I got to put this on Ginger Brute in case they do have a, what do you call effect? Can't be blocked except by creatures with haste. I better check, make sure they don't have any haste critters, right? Attack. Yeah. This, and this. Take that, you sacred cat. We battled through adversity. Well said, Bacon Master. At least 20%. All right, we're going to game 3. That was fun. Boy, we drew this at exactly the right time. Right when our blockers are set up, we've kind of established an air patrol or some sort of evasive ability. Why did I take out 2 Ginger Brutes? Seemed really good there. Ginger Brute, come on back, at least one of you. I'll get rid of 1 bodyguard. Let's go. Stretch. Last one. Win, lose, or draw. It's funny. Somebody in the chat of one of the YouTube videos was like, can we send you deck lists? Like, you must not have watched many of my shows. Don't send too many. It's been perfect lately. I was like, God, what was it? Like 3 months ago, man. There was... It's flattering, but it was just like, I can't. I need like a secretary some days. It's a nice problem to have. All right, here we go. And the festivities, definitely a decent card in this matchup. You know what? I'd rather have another inspector than a recruit in this matchup. Ah, shit. Sorry. I swear only about 3 times a year. I swear all the time in normal life, but I try not to on the stream in case kids are watching. Try to make it a family-friendly thing, you know? All right. Hands like this are very obvious. Scoop. We shall mulligan. Double check. Yep. Thank you for the hype. Woo-wee. Is that a pretty hand? We will keep this all day long. One, two, three. Do I get greedy? I don't think we need the seat. I'm going to lose the recruit, I think. I'll lose the brute. I'm going to lose the recruit. Done. Too many ground critters. Too buffed up. There's a problem already. All right, do like seeing that. Same logic, I'm gonna lead with the seat because it's the one I want least in case they do have some sort of artifact hate here. This way we can power out a lot of stuff, have a 3-3 flyer next turn, and a ginger brood if things don't improve. It's nice to have prismatic right about now. Okay, this is the plan. There it is, double life. Yikes. It's for a turn. If I'm right, they'll go to 22. Yep. Spirit linking a... if that doesn't teach you the rule, nothing will. Life link, spirit link. Two different effects. If anything, hopefully you've learned that today. Change of plans. We have got glitter food. Sun chaser. Into glitter. Did that backwards. That hurts. Let's go here. Boom, boom. Turn on our dude. Start smashing. It might be wiser to put that on Ginger Brute. Could technically give that pro black. And sit there and block us all day long. Land that on Scourge. Yikes. Ay, 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 ay. I think the plan now is to sit back with the Sun Chaser and try and kill the Scourge with the Prismatic. Can't let this continue very much longer. Very much longer. Can I wait for the 49er game tomorrow? Big football fan. Glad I got rid of the Ardent Recruit. So now there's a big wall looking him down. I like this draw a lot. Glitter. No glitter. Yes. We shall return this. We'll play it. We'll just sit back. And now I can gain life. Yeah. I'm going to block that dude. We're going to lean on strands to prevent black. Just in case there's a few bit more first strike tricks available. There is only one card in their hand. Feeling all right here. And we got the life gain of Ginger Brute. As tempting as it is because of lifelink to, you know, start gaining like 9 a turn and swinging. Against this opponent, this deck list, I should say, I think the correct angle is to lob it on Ginger Brute. Yeah. I can't glitter. All right. Now I have the same trick if I just run over with Sun Chaser. Ooh, this is getting really spicy. I love how sneaky these draws are turning. Makes it look like we're kind of stultified, but we're not. There is one card in their hand. Let's attack for 3. Meaning, you know, I return that land. We still have the same play as last turn, and we have it offensively here, too, in case something goes sideways. Yeah, they've got the standard bearer out, though. Gotta respect that. Okay. think we're going to get there, guys. I can feel the magical force. Easy to miss. Yes. Click very carefully here. Play it again. Look like we don't have anything to do. We have all kinds of things to do. We just have to stop them from gaining four life a turn. It's getting old quick. This looks a lot more attackable. I think we will be using strands here. I just don't want it to have like a... Don't play the land, opponent. They are playing very respectfully. Game three. We'll see if we can, what we can pull off here. Like that, but. Do an investment turn here. So we do have bodyguard, so we can stop them from gaining life. I'll invest here this turn. I don't know why I call it that. It's just, you know, I have the prismatic play next turn. We've got bodyguard for this turn. So we'll do this here. Drop here. Make this only haste. Only problem here is it got an instant effect. We're in trouble with our Sun Chaser, but so far so good. We can always save it with bodyguard. Don't care too much about bodyguard in this situation. And I can always block with Hawk, sacrifice, pro-black it, and at least lose the Umbra. And they don't gain any life. Then we strands. So we've got a lot more attacking options now. Sometimes strands can really hinder you, but that's bad play. Really respecting the board state here. Drum. I like that. We still promote it, and it looks like we can't even cast Prismatic. I mean, you look at my mana, you're just like, how's he going to get to three? It's pretty obvious, but I think that's a natural mistake. Well, let's attack for just three. Next turn, I'll bring out the Brute. I mean, we're kind of showing what we've got. It's like, why didn't he attack with Brute? I'll just pretend I forgot. I forget plenty of times. Maybe that's what happened. Sometimes in other lists, like with my Benevolent Blessing Thopter list, you know, you can throw on Benevolent Blessing onto the Standard Bearer, call white, and then throw on glitters on your own stuff. So you don't really need gutshot abilities and stuff for Standard Bearer if you build white that way. I was going to say right, but there's a lot of ways to attack this metagame. New PC equals a lot longer shows. A little less stressed about, used to be the 2-hour mark. My old PC would always have some sort of issue or it would clash with Twitch or Magic or something. And towards the end there, I haven't turned that thing on in a good month. PCs are like people. It's weird. You don't use them. They just wear, it's like, it has nothing but rest, batteries charged, and I'm sure if I turned it on, it would take a lot longer to start up. It's weird. Aldrain's favorite martial artist, Brute Lee. Good call. I like this draw. So now I can keep powering up Brute. This is most likely to get eaten by something, so that's why I want to use it. Haste. We have the ruse. Shall I attack with the Glint Hawks here? Or I just keep the slow roll going? I mean, I could sacrifice to the... I could power that up offensively if he doesn't have a trick. Yeah, I like this. Making sure we tap the Scourge for the mana here. All right, so we're going to call... Actually, no. Yeah, kind of sucks. Now my bodyguard's tapped. I forgot this mana. Oh, no. I'm right. Boop. Nothing like an offensive strands, right? We'll call black. We still have bodyguard backup. And we can cast strands, too. Do they have strands of their own? Double checking. Black. Do we lose the Umbra finally? Uh-oh, they got a trick. The Blessing. See, if Bodyguard would wasn't so biased, we could throw it on there. Okay, nothing's going to happen here. We don't lose a guy. They lose a card. We lose half a card in strands, but we end up hitting for six. That's good times. Now the mystery card is revealed. Slippers, you say? No, my old PC definitely had something wrong in the, what do you call it, department, just hardware. That last year or so, it even started up a little funky. Okay, gain your life. I don't mind one here. Feels like we're going to pull this one off, everyone. They're hellbent, which feels pretty good here. Hey, I was just about to call out that card. Power of positive. Woo! Draw two cards. Ew! Shall we play a pretty card or another artifact? Let's go artifact. Let's attack stuff with haste. Boop. Should I come over with everything again? I shall. Hiya! Not you. And not you. Hiya. Let's do that. Cool. You've heard artifacts' feelings. You look at the board, you're like, how could this guy lose? But I love me some combat math. Field Surgeon, there's a card. Not many people play anymore. They are hell-bent. Yeah, I think I'm going to save my strands. Shall I? Shall I not? No. I will use strands now. A few reasons for this. I still can use my bodyguard this way. We shall say black. And hopefully we hit some alacrity. Boop! They have the alacrity with the first strike, right? Okay. Umbra's down. Things are looking pretty meek on our opponent's side. They have diversified, but it might not have been the best move. I guess double spirit link doesn't matter, right? Well, I took the heroic out of my heroic and just made it all Thopters, Healers, Hawks. It's already got an enchantment on it, if you think about it. All right, that's a pretty easy play here. I just pro black our Scourge and they don't get anything. That first strike is a problem. We can bodyguard. Get our, oh yeah, we have the win next turn. They're hellbent. I've got this. I have to block and sacrifice. Everybody see it? I let this hit. They go to five, and that's, I can't get there, but I can get to four with the help of Ginger Brute. No, because then I'd have to bodyguard that. I have to let this hit. I was counting bodyguard twice. I can't save the Vault Scourge with it that way. First strike is going to give them a lot of life. That's eight. I think I just have to top deck something. Yeah. That's four. Yeah, I can get there if I just use bodyguard offensively on whatever he blocks, which will be the Sun Chaser that allows me to attack with everything. He gains one. We got it. We attack with everything, and we stop him with the bodyguard from using anything. Or we could just draw Harsh Sustenance and win. That'd be pretty cool, too. I don't know if this really does anything for us, playing this. Let's make our Ginger Brute unblock. Actually, if he wants to... No, that's dumb. Block here. Attack with everything in the air, anyway. I think this gets us there. At least stop him from gaining life. He's probably got to stop here. We call block on that. They don't gain any life. And we get in for six. Boom. All right. Great game there, Vidar. I think I'm saying that right. All right. Well, 3-2 on the day. That's not too bad. Hey, what happened here? Why am I looking at this and not this? Ha. Go over the list here real quick. And our little segment we like to call... Well, let me see. What did we learn? I'm not quite sure I like this build over the original Brute Squad. I know a lot of you wanted me to play a Glitter Brute style list. I have done so. I've checked that off my plate. But when we look at the original Brute Squad, bloop, we have quite a few more. We've got double Journey access. We still have the same mana base. A lot of creatures are the same. The Husk, you could always play the... might be the optimal build to just replace Husk with the Vault Scourge. It just seems like you always run in a red list when you do that. And this one runs a little bit different sideboard. And obviously the Tooth of Chisgora. But there might be some more design space here. It was tough to find the four spots for Glitter, but this one runs one more blast effect because the Harsh Sustenance is very important and needs to be there. Next week, maybe we'll have a new rogue list. Probably won't be all that competitive, but I just wanted to showcase some of the new cards. I'll show you where it's at right now. I'm sure some of you are, Glitters is massive in this format. So I went with I won't even go over the sideboard here. It's what I've got so far for the deck I've been tweaking. If you play me this weekend, you'll probably see that I'm on this list. I started out with four Drowned Sorrows. I went to two. It's running the very old package of Sign and Blood and three of this new card, the Rowan's Grim Search, which is obviously awesome with Hopeless Nightmare as its cast trigger. We have quite a bit of creature kill. We've got a clock here, sort of a clock and the defensive hit there, kind of a concession of what needed in this format, in all of the four Gotten Gains and Dogged Pursuit. So this deck just keeps like tick-tock, tick-tock, you keep going around. And what's cool about this too is that this is an enchantment, and so if they kill it with like a lightning bolt, which is very common, you just sacrifice it in response and get quite a bit out of it. But again, look at this count, 22. That's what it's taken to really hit consistent math on this to hit the second turn blood and stuff. It's still not there, but if you have any recommendations, I'm all ears. Hit me up, propaganda@gmail.com. Hopefully I'll have it tuned and ready to show you guys next week. It'll probably go 2-3 or something. Not the most competitive list, but again, I just always trying to flex the creative angles of like, you know, it's so easy to go into a Blackburn state with this list, but by doing this and focusing your mind in a different direction, a lot of times you can arrive at a different decision tree and something you might not have seen. Oftentimes it doesn't happen, but that's how I get there. Anyway, thank you for that, Prostate Pirate. And yeah, anyway, guys, we'll see you same time, same place next week on Propaganda. Until then, we shall, let's go out with the Astrolabe Warehouse, for those of you that know the card that got banned. Adios.
Arkham Discount Astrolabe Warehouse, your one-stop shop for astrolabes. From Arkham to Ethereum, our astrolabes come in all shapes and sizes, perfect for any occasion. Use them to navigate, calibrate, estimate, or melt them down and masticate. Arkham Discount Astrolabe Warehouse. Come see our amazing selection of astrolabes. Buy four and get the next four free. Now with over 10 locations in New Argyle. Arkham's Discount Astrolabe Warehouse. And remember, if the name Arkham's not on it, you better pawn it.